Welcome everybody. Today we're going to talk about how you can improve your squat quality with contraption squats. Get up and get down, get up
and get down. All right, Chad, today is all about obviously contraption squats. What in the world are contraption squats and why do we need to use them?
Contraption squats are just a way to block someone's feet to keep them from moving around. Typically, they're going to need to be used for those athletes that, you know, wherever you put their feet, wherever you, the coaches tell the individual they want their feet, you know, when they start squatting down, they might slide around a little bit so they can get more depth so they can maintain better quality. So I stumbled across these, just this idea many years ago at this point. My wife was doing something similar, so I stole it from her and I kind of just played with it and experimented and came up with this general basic setup that we need here, that we can control people's feet. We can get a starting point with elevation, with the amount of turnout that they're using, and just progress from there. Now, when I first did this, it was all about controlling their feet and saying, okay, I'm gonna play with this and see what happens, but I think what's gonna happen is that, yes, their feet are gonna be blocked in the position, which is going to allow them to squat with a more stable foot position, but I thought that it was going to create less quality up through the rest of the body because they were using a different squat stance that was more difficult for them. But what I found is that for most people that did this, especially if we found the right amount of elevation, it improved their quality immediately. Now, I'm not saying it fixed everything, but it's about, you know, applying something like this if you need to in extreme cases for a certain amount of time to help you make change, to help you learn a better foot position. And if you think about it, or when I thought about it, it started to make sense that if someone is starting with a better quality, stronger foot position, and they can maintain that as they squat down, it does make sense that their quality would be improved from the feet up through the rest of the body, right? So what we do is, as you can see, Aaron was backed on this with his weightlifting shoes on. I do recommend wearing weightlifting shoes with this. And typically we're gonna use this after you've done a general warm-up, and we've done videos on that and stuff like that, and I would recommend that. But these are for, say, someone that is struggling with depth and quality in their squat, with their overhead squats, their back squats, and their front squats. They can still keep those in their program, keep the weight way down, and say, hey, you know what? I'm not gonna worry about getting stronger for a while. I'm gonna worry about fixing my position and my mobility. So you replace the squats in your program with light contraption squats. What you guys just saw there is a back squat. So we've got those weightlifting shoes on. The protocol that we typically do is, you know, a couple sets with high elevation, a couple sets with medium elevation, and then progressing down to the level surface if we can, okay? So since we're starting with high elevation, that's gonna be about this size of a plate or maybe even a little bit higher. The dumbbell is there to block the heels from sliding in, okay? So what we wanna do is find a dumbbell. For me, I always recommend about a shoulder width apart stance with toes at a 0 degree turnout up to about a 15 degree turnout. But if you're wider than that and you don't feel comfortable making a big change, then you can just say, let me just exaggerate my stance a little bit, and you can find the appropriate width of dumbbell for yourself. Notice that this 15 pound dumbbell is a little bit more narrow than this 20 pound dumbbell, and so on. So you could even, some athletes may even use a 10 pound or a 25 or a 30 pound to get the appropriate width. But the point is that we want to exaggerate. Now, what I found is that most athletes that I've come across have been able to make an extreme change. So say from 2 inches outside of shoulder width all the way into shoulder width and a straighter foot, because they're locked in a position and they can maintain that, and that better foot position, as I said earlier, helps them maintain better quality up through the rest of the body. But for Aaron, to hit him shoulder width, that we found that this 15 pound dumbbell does it. These heavy plates on the outside are to help control how much the toes are turned out. So Aaron, if you'll step in here. Now, it's important anytime you're elevating your heels with plates that you are pretty far forward. So Aaron, step just a, there you go. So he's got just an inch or two of his heels on this elevated surface. Otherwise, Aaron, back up a little bit, even more. So notice here, and I see a lot of athletes do this, and notice that he's just rocking back and forth. We don't wanna do that. We wanna be more stable than that. So go ahead and go back forward. But you can see how this dumbbell is going to block those heels from coming in. But now the heavy plates allow us to control his feet from not turning out, but how much turnout that we're using. So we can open those up and then he would be turned out more, or we could exaggerate even further in, right? So that would be with a slight toe turn in. For a lot of athletes, I want them to develop the ability over time to maybe do some lightweight exaggerated squats with their toes turned in slightly, just again to exaggerate. But for the most part, the extent of the exaggeration we're trying to get to is straight ahead. So for Aaron, we would do something like toes turned out about 5 degrees for the first set. So Aaron, if you wanna go here, and we're just using back squats again, you can go up to as much as 50% for your protocol as you go up. Typically, we're gonna say 3 to 5 reps for a 3 to 5 second pause in the bottom on each rep. And we'll just do 3 here for demo purposes. And as you guys can see, Aaron can almost touch his butt on the dumbbell here, so which indicates that he doesn't really need to be using these, but obviously we're just doing them for demo. And go ahead and come up and rack it. So what we're gonna do from there, the next step, is we're gonna turn his toes in just a little bit. So I'm gonna move them about 1 inch on each side, or however much I need to position that foot straight ahead. When I'm looking at if the foot is straight or not, I'm using the inside of his foot as a line. So what that looks like on the outside is that it looks like the toes or the feet are actually turned out slightly, but I'm using the inside of the foot as a marker. And so those are now lined up straight. So we would do a set there, and then we would actually go down in elevation. Get some smaller plates. As you will see here, I'm just gonna replace it like that. And one thing that might be a little bit confusing is what we're elevating on here. Notice the curve of the plate. I like the curve of the plate here because anyone that needs contraption is more than likely squatting with a wide turned out foot and their arch is always collapsing. So by being on this curved plate, it can help force you more to the outside. So there is a purpose for this plate as well. But we've gone down in elevation and we're gonna go back out slightly to turn those toes back out to where they were before. Since we're down in elevation, yeah, and now we're back opened up to about 5 degrees for Aaron there. He would do a set and then we would bring them back in, okay? He would do a set, and then if everything is looking good, we'll take out the elevation. Moving those out of the way, keep him inside of the progression, going down to the level surface, opening back out about 5 degrees. And once again, as long as everything is looking good and quality, we'll do a set there. We'll then do a set with the toes turned back to straight ahead. And keep this in mind. This is about working at your level. We wanna see quality. I'm okay with lightweight with a little bit of breaking on 1 or 2 reps because that is just you understanding where you're at and pushing your limits. But we wanna get most of our reps in with quality. And so if that means, and I've had people before that had to do all high elevation, you know, and I'm just playing with the turnout of their toes. And as the weeks go, the idea, whether it's today, or whether it's workout through workouts, or whether it's through weeks, we want to progress down in elevation, and we want to do reps with different amounts of turnout of the toe, mm-hmm. right? And the idea there is progressing and trying to teach your feet to stay where you want them to be while still squatting low and with good quality.
And you can also go back and forth and superset this with a mobility drill that you may need. For example, if you really liked ankle mobility, go back and forth between maybe an ankle rock, a banded joint mobilization, or something like that.
No doubt about it. It's absolutely a big part of the process. And you know, another video that we shot was on a warm-up sequence where you're alternating back and forth between a warm-up squat variation and a mobility drill. And if you can find the 1 or 2 parts of your body that are most limited, you do that for your 10 to 15 minute warm-up. You know you're still working on your squat. You're not ready to push weights and lift heavy and work on strength yet. You're working on mobility and position. Do your back squats as contraption back squats, mm-hmm. and that's an opportunity for you to get more reps and time in with the mobility drills that you need the most.
So the big reason someone would want to do this is they really suffer a big issue with quality control and depth. Their feet spin out, their feet collapse in, and they need to take a step back from pushing bigger weights. Still maybe continue your snatches and cleans, but you may need to pull that back a little bit. But say, hey, for this next block, this 8 to 12 week pattern, I'm gonna focus solely on improving my quality of depth, the quality of technique, making sure my feet don't spin. This is something that they would put in. And we'll make sure that we put in the part of the video, the full write-up.
Progression.
The full progression of this. But yeah, so this would be something that you would use for about 8 to 12 weeks.
It's someone that has what I call crazy feet. Crazy feet means that you, even if your feet stay where you have them, if they're, you know, wide and turned out and your arches are collapsing, you know, your knees are kind of caving to the inside, that would still be crazy feet. Or if your feet move around at all, slide in or out, or if you just lose stability on your foot, like I said, even if your feet stay in the same position, this is good for you to use, you know, because probably what's happening is something up through the rest of the body is compensating a little bit or a lot. And I'm confident if you will lock your feet into position, and if, especially if you find the appropriate amount of elevation, you'll find and feel better quality here. But that is the person that it's for, that person with crazy feet that squats all the time with lack of foot stability and lacking quality up through the rest of their body.
Perfect. All right, guys. Well, hope you enjoyed today's video and learned something new about contraption squats. This is something I had never really seen until I started working with Chad and saw this, and I think it can be really helpful for a lot of people out there. So again, go follow Chad on YouTube. He's got a lot of great content on his site. And if you have any questions for us, let us know in the comments section below. Again, thank you guys so much for checking out today's video. Again, if you're not subscribed to the Squat U YouTube channel, subscribe now so you don't miss out any awesome future videos that we do. And until next time, guys, happy squatting. They say that energy flows where attention goes, so I pay no mind. Why waste my time with all these negative cats scratching? So caught up in their egos, these people have lost.